You just woke up, stepped into the shower, letting the water flow gently wake you up and make you active for the rest of the day. Alas, your spa-like experience has a cost associated. You just wasted 95 liters of pure drinking water straight down the drain. Yes, within a shower of about 10 minutes, approximately one person consumes 1 lakh drinking glasses of water every year. Yes, that is huge, isn't it? And there is a famous quote by Jacques Cousteau that says that water in the form of liquid is very rare. It's extremely rare in the universe. And away from Earth, it is in the form of gas. So moisture is the blessed treasure. So if you don't want to commit suicide and you want to be blessed in future as well, start to preserve it. Hello, everyone. I am Richa, Mrs. Asia Universe 2020, an author, founder of Chitrakari, and a robotic enthusiast who represented my college at NASA Kennedy Space Center, Florida, 2013. I am an engineer by qualification and a product manager by profession. I am here today to give a talk on the topic cleaning water bodies. It's a very ordinary topic, right? But I'm going to talk about cleaning water bodies through robots. So there are tons of plastic waste that are being thrown into river almost every day. Different kind of waste, such as industrial waste, sewage, and whatnot, are being dumped into our rivers every single day. It needs to be taken out and then treated with the help of river cleaning machinery, which is not only cost intensive, but also requires a lot of space. So the idea here is to develop robots, autonomous robots that can remove or treat the water surfaces or the water bodies. Using the student's analytical brain and the cutting edge technology that we have, we can create those cost efficient robots that even the local government bodies can start to use to ramp up their cleanliness drive at a large scale. But you might be thinking, why I am talking today? Why I? Being an engineer myself, who had participated in NASA's Lunar Robotics Mining Competition 2013, where the task was to design a robot, a lunar excavator, that would dig the surface of the soil, and the soil thus collected, we had to calculate the moisture content in it. So having developed a robot myself, and then talking about how robots will enable the water cleanliness will make sense to you, right? And also at the same time, being an electronics engineer and then talking about sensors would be more relatable to you, isn't it? So let's begin. 4th October 2019, it is estimated that 70% of India's surface water is unfit for drinking. Every day, around 40 million liters of wastewater is being dumped into our rivers. This is huge, right? As India grows and urbanizes, its water is getting toxic. Crores and crores of rupees are being invested in the massive cleaning of our rivers like Ganga and Yamuna. But still, some experts feel that instead of the mammoth sewage treatment plants that we have, which are cost intensive, difficult to sustain, we can have some indigenous measures that can tap the local wisdom and that might be more efficient way. Either ways, India needs to ramp up its cleanliness drive on war footing basis. But the first step towards it is to understand the extent of the problem. These days, there are different varieties of robots that are being created all around the world, depending upon how large the problem is and depending upon the amount of cleanliness that is required there. So starting off with India in 2013, a robot was developed called Robot. It was a complete autonomous robot with a minimal human intervention. It used to detect chemical pollution in the river water bodies through GPS sensors and the onboard cameras. It used to suck the polluted water and then filter it, treat it, and then release the fresh water back into it. It had panoramic zoom camera and anti-fog lights, which allowed it to navigate freely 24/7 in all weather conditions. It also had an array of solar panels which helped it to navigate easily without using much energy. This was first kind of robot. Similarly, 15th August 2018, students like you, a small venture with a great promise, was shown by 12 engineering students from Kerala where they developed Fenbot robotic technology. Fenbot robotic technology is capable of finding 60 samples of pollutant in a river in less than 1 minute. In less than 1 minute, 60 samples of pollutants. Not only calculating the number of pollutants in the river, it also used to detect the source of that pollutants. So like these, there are many innovations and different kinds of robots that are being made all across the world. Scientists are on it. And the results shown by them are phenomenal. But despite that, we are facing the climate crisis. Despite that, we are facing water crisis. But I do believe that there is hope. There is hope because in India, around 40% of our population, which is 24 years or younger. So we are a young country. We have innovation, we have technology, we have means. What we need is collaboration and mass effort. And we can do that, right? We, the students, can contribute in this fight. How you can contribute in this fight, I'll tell you. There are 5 ways. First, collect data. So the one thing that a person can trust after God is data. Start to collect data about how grim the river situation in India is. The consequences of the river contamination, start to collect data about it. The essence is, when you start to work on any problem, you must need to realize how huge is the problem. Trust me, this time it is really huge. Second, define the solution. As I already mentioned, that there are various kinds of robots, like robots that can treat water, robots that can clean the surface of the water, robots that can determine the pollutants in the river. So you need to define your solution on which kind of robot do you want to work upon. So first, you need to define the solution that you'll be working on. Third, and the very most important, learn programming and robotics. Automation is the future. Let me tell this word again. Automation is the future. Autonomous robots that are being created and that does not require human intervention is very popular today. This is because the world and India is going through a revolution right now, and that revolution is artificial intelligence and machine learning. Artificial intelligence and machine learning can transform the abilities and the capabilities of the robot to take over the tasks that were once carried out by humans. So that's huge, right? Fourth, increase the efficiency. As I mentioned, that the bots are already there. Once you have defined your solutions, once you have collected the data and your robot is ready for development, you need to ensure that how compact the robot can be made, how much water it can clean every day. Because if 70% of India's water is unfit for drinking, how much water it can clean up every day to reach to that level? Because we need to ramp up our cleanliness drive as soon as possible. Fifth, reduce the cost. So cost and finances are very important in everybody's life. So are they here also? So you need to ensure that you build cost-efficient robots so that local government bodies, municipal corporations, and NGOs can start using it at a very large scale. Because once they'll start using it at a very large scale, then only they'll be able to reach to the future that we want, right? So, and also this reduction in cost will increase their demand to a large extent. And when the demand will be high, the drive will automatically increase exponentially. Having said that, the robots are the future of the cleanup effort. As I mentioned by different examples and the definitions that I gave you, you can very well realize that robotics is going to be the future of the cleanliness drive and the cleanliness effort all across the world. Scientists are already in that race. You as an student also can contribute into it. So the idea is to develop cost-efficient, energy-efficient, good-capacity robots that the local government bodies can start to use at an extensive and large level so that we can create the India that we want. We need to work and act on it now. Because remember, when all trees are cut, when all animals are hunted, when all waters are polluted, and when all air is unsafe to breathe, then will you discover that you can't eat money. So act, start acting on it now, because every drop you drop counts. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.